Good morning and welcome to worship. It's good to gather as God's people this day. We're thankful for your presence as we continue our celebration of Easter. If you're tuning in online, you're watching later because we can't stream live today. We're having all kinds of tech gremlins causing us trouble, but we will get the worship service up as quickly as possible following worship. Reminder that we will post it to both Facebook and YouTube, so you'll be able to watch on either channel. If you're watching online later, we still appreciate a text message letting us know you're participating with any prayer concerns, 419-595-4591. Following worship, we do have coffee and fellowship with homemade chocolate chip cookies in the Nest, which is out the side door around the corner and across the hall. So I invite you to stay for some fellowship there. There's also a sign up in there next to the cookies for donations for cookies for fellowship over the next couple of weeks. So if you're interested and able to help with that, that would be fantastic. Our book group will be meeting this week at 2 p.m., reading The Good Life. They'll be meeting down in the library at 2. Our next Hope for Salem workday will be Saturday, the 22nd, as work continues building the walls on the second floor. Next week, a warning is the Glass City Marathon. Last year was fantastic. In fact, I went to a meeting with the race officials and the village officials and the police and said, boy, this is the best we've ever had it. I said, keep the route the same, and they said, can't, because Secor Road is closed where they run normally. But our experience has been the best way to get down to Hope is to come down Secor Road. If, in fact, you get stopped, say, at Kenwood by the Toledo police, shoot over to Manchester and come down towards Indian there. Manchester is one street west of Costco, and it runs all the way from Central across Kenwood down to Indian. Once you get around the village police officers will make sure that you're able to get in. We'll have our parking lot coned off until time for worship so that we don't have all of the runners park there when they get panicked about getting to the race. But you won't be able to come down Bancroft, and you certainly won't be able to come down Indian. And of course, Secor is already closed because of the bridge construction. So again, the easiest way to get to Hope is most likely down Secor to Indian or to our Secor parking lot. Next week, we have a Life in Christ class following the 11 o'clock service, which is our membership class. For those that are interested in more information about ministry here at Hope, and that'll be in the Nest. If you're interested, let us know. We will make sure there's enough food for everyone because we'll begin with lunch. On the 30th, Pastor Chuck Campbell will be offering an internet safety seminar, great for teens as well as adults. We'll have it at 10 and at noon, so plan on participating in that as well. Pastor Chuck does these workshops both on human trafficking, on internet safety, all over the place, and oftentimes is doing two or three of them a week, and it's great to have him be able to do it here for us at Hope. The weekend of May 6th and 7th, we have a weekend of service. We used to do this the weekend after Labor Day when we did God's Work Our Hands, but we've been doing our outdoor picnic since COVID then, so we moved it to May, and we've got a number of opportunities to serve. Our goal is to have something, and you'll see an announcement next week in the announcement page, but our goal is to have something for everybody and level of service. On Saturday, we'll be working here cleaning up around the building as well as doing a neighborhood cleanup down at Salem. We're working on something that we'll be putting together for Old Orchard. We'll probably be writing notes to some of our shut-ins and things as well. So know that and watch for more stuff as we announce what the opportunities will be on the 6th and 7th. VBS registration is available online, and volunteer sign-up is available as well for our Hero Hotline, which is June 19th through 23rd. Backpack, so Hope, items that are needed, continued cereal, green beans, soup, and peanut butter as we continue to feed about 35 children every week. With that, we continue our sermon series, A New Reality. I invite those of you that are able to stand as we begin with our first song, Trust in You.
Warrior, King of the Fire. know what tomorrow brings. There's not a day ahead that you have not seen. So in all things be my life and breath. I want what you want, Lord, and nothing less.
When you don't move the mountain, I could walk through where you don't give the answers. As I cry out to you, I will trust, I will trust, I will trust in you.
Yeah,
I will trust in you.
Join in our call to worship. I shared your good news without restraint. Go and make disciples of all nations. I have spoken of your faithfulness to all. Go and make disciples of all nations. I have not concealed your love and salvation. Go and make disciples of all nations. Let us pray. Oh Lord, sometimes we still question your presence, even when you are right in front of us. Fill us with faith in believing your promises simply because you are trustworthy. In Jesus' name, amen. We come to confession and forgiveness. We confess our sins before God and one another. God of new life, you have created and redeemed all things through the gift of your Son. Yet we often live as though it makes no difference for us. We choose to remain stuck in old patterns, cling to the familiar and safe, and refuse opportunities to step out in courage and faith. Forgive our cowardice, stubbornness, and willful disobedience. Amen. The Lord is risen, and with his resurrection brings a new day, a new chance to make new choices and renewal between people, creation, and Creator. Rejoice that you've been forgiven and called sisters and brothers of our Savior and Lord. Amen. We join in our next song, Love.
Yeah, everybody hurts sometimes, I know that's what they say. But right now it seems this loneliness will go away, yeah. Can anybody feel this heartache? Is anyone around? It's like we're running round in circles, we can't catch our breath. We can't enjoy the moment when we always want what's next, yeah. Thinking you're
of you seated. A reminder that clipped to the front of your bulletin is a connection card. We do encourage everyone here to fill one of those out, especially if any contact information is new or has changed. As you flip those over, you will see some space for prayer requests, as well as a space to look at more information or to volunteer to help with Vacation Bible School in June. You can then place those connection cards in the offering basket as you come up for worship, or as you come up for communion later in the service. Our gospel reading today is from the 28th chapter of Matthew. Now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshiped, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age." The Gospel of our Lord. I invite our children to come up and join me. Good morning. Good morning. Hi. How are you all this morning? Good. All right. How about if I say good morning, then you say good morning? Do you think we can do that? Good morning. All right. We might have to work on a little more energy later, but that's okay. So in our reading, do you all remember what happened last Sunday? Do you remember what last Sunday was? I know it was a whole week ago. It was Easter. That's right. And we celebrated Jesus rising from the dead. Hi, Nolan. Do you want to play with us? Yeah? Here. We celebrated Jesus rising from the dead. And we remember that Jesus is with us always. Well, today, our reading had Jesus meeting his disciples. After he was raised from the dead, he went to meet his disciples and he said, "I have a job for all of you." Do you hear what that job was? That they are to go and tell everybody about who Jesus is and teach them all the things that Jesus had already taught them. So what are some of the things that Jesus taught his disciples? Can you think of something that Jesus teaches us? That we should love each other? Yeah. That we should love God? Yeah. That we should help people who need help? Yeah. That we should be generous? Yeah. Ooh, we might want to watch the basket. Sorry. Thank you. Jesus teaches us all of these things, and he wants us to teach other people. So this week, I think we should all see if we can tell one other person something that Jesus taught us. Do you think we can do that? So tell one person this week something about who Jesus is, and share what Jesus taught us to do. And we might share that with words, or we might share that by examples. Do you think you can give an example this week of how we love each other and how we help each other? I bet you guys can all do that, right? You guys have been sharing that in First Communion, right? How you love and help each other and how you've shared God's love sometime in the past week. Well, I'm encouraging all of you to do that once, at least once this coming week, okay? And you know what? I bet the adults out there can do that too. I bet they can. You think so? You think they can do it? I think they can. Let's fold our hands and pray. Dear God, thank you for coming and being with us, for promising to be with us always. Help us to share your love and your teaching both in our words and our actions this week, so that others can know you. In your name we pray, amen. Thank you all so much. You can go back to your seats. You can go back to your seat. So as we start this new, this series in Easter, this new reality, looking at the idea that Jesus, or looking at the truth that Jesus was raised from the dead and came to be with his disciples, challenged them and gave them authority, and how that impacts both them in the early church and still impacts our reality today. That this is something new. Jesus rising from the dead had never happened before, and it has not happened since. And that impacts our very lives still today. But looking back, we remember last week, right? That this is still the Easter season. So it's good to remember that first Easter where the women went to the tomb and found it open. And an angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples he has been raised from the dead and indeed is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him." And the women did just what the angel had asked. And so this week, we gather with the disciples in Galilee, just as they were instructed. Probably one of the first times the disciples actually fully followed the instructions. They gather on the mountain as Jesus directed them, as the angel directed them, and they worship and they doubt. And there, they are commissioned for something bigger. That's what we typically call this gospel reading for today. Simply, it's usually known as the Great Commission. We know what a commissioning is, right? So when you are sent, you are set aside for a task, for a job, for a role. So when we have mission trips, we will often commission those going on the mission trip, set aside for that purpose. When we have programs here, whether it be DIT or adult education or VBS, we might commission our leaders for that. It can be all kinds of different things, but you are commissioned, you are set aside for a purpose. And here are the disciples who had previously scattered, who had asked a lot of questions, who had run away when Jesus was arrested, but now they have come back. They're a little bit fragile. They have a lot of doubt still in the midst of their worship. And those are the ones that Jesus commissions for a purpose. "Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you." We often focus on the beginning part of that passage, to go and make disciples and baptize. But I think the ending of that verse is one of the parts we might not focus on as much. And yet it's really important, teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. It's important because up until this point in the gospel, Jesus had asked his disciples to do a lot of things. He had asked them to go and tell other people about him. He had asked them to go and heal in his name. He'd asked them to feed people with bread and fish. He'd asked them to do all kinds of things, but never had he asked them to teach. To this point, teaching was Jesus' task alone. And he repeatedly amazed the crowds. He amazed the Pharisees. He amazed everyone as one who taught with authority, who taught with authority that they couldn't understand. But now, teaching, that authority that has been given to Jesus, is given to the disciples to teach everything that I have commanded you. And what exactly did Jesus teach? You think that becomes the sticking point a lot as we go out into the world and go and tell, is remaining true to Jesus' teaching. The church, in all of its love and generosity, has not always followed this commission well. The idea to go and baptize for centuries became a mandate to go and forcefully change, make people adapt to a new religion, to lose their own culture, to become disciples by force. That doesn't really follow with the teaching of Jesus all that well. Still, today we focus on one part or another. The church today, divided in the public sphere at least, that we can either preach a gospel of repentance or we can preach a gospel of love, and the two seemingly in culture contradict each other. So people want to know, as I talk about and as I go in places and people who have never met me find out I'm a pastor, I either get a very negative reaction or a positive reaction based upon their view or their perception of what the church teaches in Jesus' name. You might have run across, and I think that's one of the fears as we go out to make disciples or to talk about our Christian faith, is what other perceptions people might have about the church. So what has Jesus taught? There is a call to repentance. There is also a call to love. And how do we hold those together? If we look at what Jesus taught, we go back to the 5th and 6th and 7th chapters of Matthew with the Sermon on the Mount. That includes the Beatitudes. Blessed are the poor in spirit. Blessed are the peacemakers. It includes the teaching of the Lord's Prayer, that we are not called to pray in big phrases so others can hear us, but instead to pray to God for the things that we need, which involves asking for and receiving and offering forgiveness and grace. It involves being called to love and pray for our enemies, to care for others and to treat them in the way that we wish to be treated, to return our focus from our own wants and desires to God, to care for the worlds that God has made. This is how we make disciples. Not by force or by fear or by passively hoping that people will somehow just become a disciple, but by living out this teaching, by talking about it not in order for fear or judgment, but as a part of who we are and who we are called to be. Because as the disciples were once commissioned, we have been commissioned as well. In our baptism, we are called to live our faith in the world. We are called not to live for ourselves, but to live for others, and to boldly proclaim the one who has saved us, who has risen from the dead, and who promises to go with us always. It's the other promise at the end of this gospel, the last words of Jesus in the Gospel of Matthew. And remember, I am with you always, to the end of the age. As Jesus gives his disciples all authority to teach all the things and to go to all the places, he also sends us with a promise that he is still here with us, that he is present in our lives as we live into this new reality, as we boldly proclaim who Jesus is to us and all of the lessons we have learned through the years, whether that be from childhood, if we are ones raised in the faith, whether it is a faith we have come to as adults. How can we boldly proclaim that in the world? Not passively just accepting what others see or want to believe the church is, but what the church means for us. What Jesus has taught us so that we may teach and proclaim that to others. To call others back to a God who loves them, to love and forgive in return. I invite you to stand as you are able as we pray together. Gracious God, we give you thanks for calling the disciples together amidst their questions and doubts, for sending them forth to proclaim your message of repentance and love, for sending us forth. Give us courage that you remain with us, that you walk with us as we proclaim your love in our words and our actions for the sake of others. In your name we pray. Amen. I invite you to continue with our next song.
Song to see. I'm living for the world to see. No.
As we come to a time of prayer, you can remain standing or be seated, whatever is a better posture for you as we pray. At the end of each petition, I'll offer the words, "Hear us, O God," and invite you to respond, "Your mercy is great." Let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need. You reveal yourself to us, God, in many ways. Open our eyes to the wonder of new life all around us and to your presence in everyone we meet. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. You long that we would reach beyond the bounds of our familiarity and comfort, O Lord. Stretch our vision to encompass your whole earthly family and give us conviction to commit our lives to the service of all people and the preservation of all earthly life. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
With our Orthodox brothers and sisters, we join in proclaiming your resurrection. Unite all Christians worldwide, regardless of denomination or affiliation, that our witness may stand as a powerful sign of your love in the world. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Bring hope out of despair, faith out of suffering, new life out of death. We raise up those in our community whom we know need special prayers. This day, Kathy, Sally, Vivian, Paul, Eleanor, Marion, and those that we now name. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Your beloved saints, are beloved to you because they remain steadfast even through their own doubts. Encourage us to follow their example that we might all be gathered together around your throne of mercy in the fullness of time. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Into your hands we place these things for which we pray and all those things which our hearts cannot speak aloud. For you hold us in mercy and grace for the sake of your Son, Jesus. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
I invite you to greet one another with a sign of God's peace. Pray. Holy God, gracious and merciful, you bring forth food from the earth and nourish your whole creation. Turn our hearts towards those who hunger in any way, that all may know your care. And prepare us now to feast on the bread of life, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Let
us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
The night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. I invite you to be seated. First, I share with you words of invitation. You do not need to be a member or a Lutheran. All are welcome to receive at this table. We're going to invite you to come forward in two lines. We'll have a basket there for any offerings as well as the connection cards and pens. As you come forward, there'll also be a bottle of hand sanitizer. As you come forward, we'll offer you a piece of bread. We have gluten-free available. If you have that need, just indicate it. And then we have a chalice that's split, so there's red wine and white grape juice. You can dip in either one. Or if you prefer to receive in individual cups, there are, again, cups of white grape juice and red wine on the carts. You return to your seats using the side aisle. The Feast of the Lamb is a celebration where all are welcome and joy abounds. Come now and partake in his body and blood, enriched by this holy food and empowered to serve as God's children in the world. Body of Christ given for you. Body of Christ given for you. Body of Christ given for you.
Our Father.
I believe in God.
I invite you to stand as you're able. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. May God, who raised Jesus from the dead, bless you, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, raise you with him in glory. Amen. We join our sending song. Let's get together.
Just one key unlocks them both. It's there at your command. Come on, people, now. Smile on your brother. Everybody get together. Try to love one another right now. Come on. Come on, people now, smile on.
together as you go into the world, remember our mission. Yeah. Live out servant love.
That's right.
Show hospitality.
Oh, yes.
Extend generosity.
How to do it.
Worship the risen Lord.
Yeah.
Go in peace, a living example of the love of Jesus Christ. Have a great week.
Come on, people now. Smile on your brother. Everybody get together. Try to love one another.